Happening right now, the race is on to approve COVID boosters for all adults. At the federal level, that could happen today.
No matter what's decided, Minnesota is expected to approve extra protection for everyone 18 plus as soon as this afternoon. Jen has everything you need to know. Good morning, Jen.
Yeah, good morning. So at last check, the health department's webpage on booster shots still listed qualifications for getting a booster. If you got Pfizer or Moderna, those qualifications like high risk, age, things like that. So we're not sure at what point that will change. But as we've been reporting all week, the health commissioner, Jan Malcolm, said earlier in the week that as soon as the end of this week, presumably today, obviously, as it is Friday, anyone 18 or older in the state will become eligible for a booster. If you got Johnson & Johnson 2 months ago or more, you are actually already eligible. But if you got Pfizer or Moderna 6 months ago, this is new to you. Commissioner Malcolm said they've already notified the federal government that they are moving ahead with this regardless of any decision on the federal level because the situation in Minnesota is so serious.
We are concerned enough about the surge, and you know our own data suggests that breakthrough cases are growing, not unexpectedly, and the data are so compelling on the value of boosters to increase that level of protection that we think it's quite urgent to move.
So on the federal level, the FDA could give the go-ahead to both Pfizer and Moderna's booster shots for adults as soon as today. They have an advisory meeting later on today. The CDC approval, that would be the final step here before those booster shots are approved for all adults. And the CDC could come out with a decision soon after that FDA meeting.
Yeah, a lot of people asking questions about boosters, and we might get some answers today about when you can get it. Jen, thank you.
Alicia, you're talking about the kids.
Yeah, push to get more kids vaccinated against COVID is growing as the number of cases in our state continues to climb. Today, Lieutenant Governor Peggy Flanagan is highlighting the kids deserve a shot vaccine incentive at Como Zoo. So at noon today, Minnesotans aged 12 to 17 are encouraged to roll up their sleeves and get fully vaccinated against COVID. Once they get their shots, they're eligible to win some fun Minnesota experiences from sporting events to entertainment. Meanwhile, the Minnetonka School District is seeing more and more students testing positive for COVID. Right now, the district has 196 active cases with 60 positive cases at Groveland Elementary alone. The students do have to stay home and quarantine, and there is an option once again for e-learning. And for students in the Shakopee Public Schools, officials there are extending their Thanksgiving break for students and staff, adding 2 days due to a rise in COVID cases in Scott County. So there's no school on Monday, November 22nd or Tuesday, November 23rd. And we do have more information and details on where you can find a vaccine shot for both you and your child right now at carelevin.com/vaccine. But as those numbers you're going to be talking about a little bit later continue to go up, more and more parents are looking for a spot to get
their
kid a shot.
Yeah, thousands of kids have already been brave and done it, about 12%. Yeah. So again, we'll be diving into those numbers in a little bit. But you can get everything you need to know about the COVID vaccine sent right to your phone. Just text the word vaccine to 763-797-7215 and we'll respond with all of our coverage, including where you can get a shot. And remember to text that number.
Tension in Kenosha, Wisconsin is getting tighter every day. We're waking up to day four of jury deliberations for the Kyle Rittenhouse trial. Tom Yamas is outside the courthouse with what to expect.
Coming up on the Today Show, we are on verdict watch here in Kenosha, Wisconsin, day four of jury deliberations. We'll hear from a legal analyst about why the jurors are taking so long, plus the one question a juror asked the judge, what exactly they wanted. We'll also hear from the sheriff of Kenosha about the temperature of the crowds protesting outside the courthouse, what he did for some of them, and what he thinks is going to happen when a verdict does come down. We'll also hear from an attorney representing some of the victims in this case, what she says the families are thinking about as the juries try to reach that verdict. It's all coming up this morning on the Today Show.
Now here's a look at today's other top stories in your morning rush. An update on breaking news we first told you about here on Sunrise. A man shot while sitting in his car in Minneapolis Wednesday night has died. Police say two men shot the victim several more times after he fell out of his car. So far, no one's been arrested. A new lawsuit claims Alec Baldwin was recklessly firing a gun on his movie set when he wasn't supposed to be. This comes a month after the actor killed Helena Hutchins on the set of Rust with a prop gun. Now the film's script supervisor is saying the gunshot wasn't called for in the script. This is the second lawsuit filed over the shooting. A man in Eagan pulls off the greatest Christmas gift for his wife, who's fighting cancer. Jack arranged to light up his entire neighborhood. The contractor he hired to do the job says it took a week to string all the lights on 49 trees. A month ago, Jack's wife Cheryl decided to stop treatment for pancreatic cancer. He says this year, he wanted to have a tunnel of lights for his wife of 54 years. If you were hoping to snag a bottle of Arby's vodka, you're out of luck. The specialty alcohol that tastes like fries came out yesterday and sold out by noon. Arby's teamed up with Minneapolis-based Tattersall Distilling to create the drinks. They made two flavors of the vodka, curly fry and crinkle fry. And that's your Friday Morning Rush.
6:07, we're taking you live from the Capitol this morning, where House lawmakers are on the verge of passing President Biden's nearly $2 trillion spending bill. The final vote scheduled for today starts at 8 a.m. It was pushed back after an eight-hour-long speech from House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy. He just finished after 4 a.m. our time. Now, the bill calls for spending on everything from health care to clean energy.
Reform and recruitment, the two pillars paving the way into the future for law enforcement in the Twin Cities.
Devon Roming and John Croman share the new plans in Minneapolis and St. Paul to get people to join the force.
In the wake of George Floyd's murder, the Minneapolis Police Department says they lost a third of their department and they're now looking to fill hundreds of positions. They have 40 full-time recruit positions open right now that they're looking to fill by December 6th. They're also looking for 50 lateral moves for police officers with experience from other departments. The pay ranges from $31 to $40. And for anyone interested, we have a link on our website where you can apply.
The U.S. Department of Justice has given the city of St. Paul a $3.7 million COPS grant. That stands for Community-Oriented Policing Services. It would allow the city to hire 30 new officers over a three-year period. So Chief Todd Axtell is definitely very excited about that news. It does come with a catch. The city would have to come up with $1.8 million in matching funds for equipment. And so now it's really in the hands of the city council and mayor to decide whether they want to accept these federal dollars.
The countdown, it is on for the Toys for Tots holiday drive. It begins on December 1st, and you'll be able to drop off gifts and monetary donations at several locations throughout the Twin Cities, including here at Care 11. Head to care11.com/toysfortots to learn more about this holiday campaign.
Friday morning is starting off cool as we look out over downtown Minneapolis. Hopefully it's going to warm up. How warm will it get? Guy's the man with the answer.
Yeah, you know, temperatures today, later on this afternoon, are going to climb into the upper 30s and low 40s, which is progress, especially from a day like yesterday. But let's dive right into things. I mean, that camera we just showed you looking over downtown Minneapolis wasn't shaken in the camera, wasn't shaken in the winds like it was yesterday morning. Winds out of the south at around 10 miles per hour. So winds not as strong as what they were yesterday getting out of the door this morning, but still enough to make it feel like the teens. 14 is the wind chill value. 24 is our current air temperature, partly cloudy to mostly cloudy skies right now. Wind chills will play an effect as we get in through the morning hours, and then notice towards the afternoon, feeling like the low 30s with temps today, again, upper 30s, low 40s. So winds will be shaving off a couple of degrees. So dress for the teens and 30s getting out of the door. Wind speeds increasing later this afternoon, clouds decreasing. Seeing maybe squeezing a few peaks of sunshine between 2 p.m. and 4 p.m. later on this afternoon. So your weekend forecast looks like this. 42 today, breaking clouds, breezy in the afternoon. Sunshine returns tomorrow with just a sun and cloud mix that will allow temperatures to warm up by a couple of degrees. And then flurries are in the forecast on Sunday. Snow, light snow as you get north of the metro. Just brief, because after this little bit of some flakes that we see on Sunday, things pretty much turning quiet for the remainder of the week. I'll step out of the way so you can see your weekend forecast, doing any traveling from Duluth, Brainerd Lakes, Detroit Lakes, Hayward. Temps in the upper 30s and low 40s today, then in the upper 30s, kind of cooling off a little bit in the northern part of the state tomorrow, and then upper 20s for the high later on Sunday with some light snow in Duluth down even into Hayward. So light flurries for the metro Sunday back home. 15 for the low Monday morning. Couple cold starts as we get into Monday, Tuesday, and then temperatures a bit more comfortable and more seasonal for Wednesday. And of course, Thanksgiving Day, we'll see a high temperature on Thanksgiving, 32, a low Thanksgiving morning of 24.
Thank you, Guy. Sunrisers, a Minnesota staple, is so desperate for snow, they're actually making their own.
Yeah, Eva's live at Afton Alps this morning. Eva, hey, you promised some snow angels. Not quite yet, it looks like.
6:27, Gia, is when Those snow angels are going to happen. You guys all better be prepared for it, because I'm going toe-to-toe with the general manager here at Afton Alps. And, you know, I would guess that he probably has some practice. So it's my first Minnesota winter. I'm going to dive right in head first. Got my toe warmers. I'm all prepared. We are so excited to be out here when they're firing up all these big snow guns in full force. We're going to talk all things snowmaking and Afton Alps. That's coming up.
Wow, the gauntlet was thrown down there. Can't wait to see that snow angel off. Then a Minnesota-based company wants you to decide when you get paid. That includes the same day you do the work. Plus,
finally, I was able to hug my son after 32 years. It is unbelievable.
The perspective we don't often hear, a mother and her difficult decision to place her son in adoption, and the reunion after years of searching. That story's at 6:45.